But we're going to see what kind of shape they're in and what they're running today.
Yeah, and the draft is about to begin. And again, I'm curious to see, the biggest mystery for me is Reunited going to be banning out King of the Hill again? Because they weren't comfortable with it last week, but maybe they've sort of put some time in the lab and now they actually want to play King of the Hill. We'll find out very, very shortly.
Yeah, I mean, nothing is going to motivate you to get better at a map mode than kind of getting whooped on it as they did. So it should be interesting. I love the King of the Hill map mode. G2 has looked pretty good on it so far, so it's going to be something that whoever faces G2 might have to prepare for. Can't wait to see this match.
All right, so reunite with the first ban. Will it be Temple of Anubis? Will it be a King of the Hill map? We wait in suspense. I kind of hope it's Temple of Anubis just to sort of keep with the theme of Temple Anubis getting horrifically beat on. But nope, it's Lijiang Tower. So
I'm just
there you go,
guessing
Hex.
you're not a fan of Temple of Anubis.
No, not at all.
I think that's your most hated map. Hanamura comes out as the ban from Flat Earth, and then Reunited follows it up by banning out Temple of Anubis.
So right now, capture point maps going down, King of the Hill maps going down. Form follows here will be either Nepal or, well, likely just Nepal to go down from Reunite if they really still hate King of the Hill.
Yeah, the first four bans already took care of the control point maps, as is tradition at this point.
Yep.
I'd like to see something new today. I wouldn't mind going to an Mbani, maybe a Hollywood. Of course, there's always Dorado. Special
Just saw
place to
Nepal
land.
going down. So Reunited definitely not cool with playing King of the Hill maps right now. They took out both King of the Hill maps in short order. So yeah, I mean they just want to play payload, payload, and more payload.
I guess if you're good at something, keep playing to your strengths. I am a little surprised that they banned out King of the Hill. I thought maybe they'd be practicing that, getting used to that as the team of grinders, as we've called them before. But we're definitely going to payload here. What do you want to see? You want to see something different, right?
Definitely want to see something different. I'd be down for Dorado.
Hey, we're.
Dorado it's a favorite, man.
Yeah, we all know I love Dorado because I like piñatas a lot and I like music. It'd be great to
Yeah,
see gringos on Dorado. That would have been kind of fitting. Hollywood, Dorado, or Numbani left. So we're either going to Hollywood or Dorado as Numbani is banned out by Flat Earth.
Nambani is going to go down. So, very close to either getting. At least we're getting a new map regardless. It's not going to be Dorado, but it will be Hollywood.
It's all right. Hollywood's a great map too. Yeah, so one of the more wide open payload maps also can be defended. For how open it is, the defense on first point is surprisingly strong. We've seen a lot of Bastion play. We've seen Soldier 76 hanging out in that cafe. We've seen Symmetras. A lot of different options for how teams want to defend this first point in Hollywood. It should be interesting to see.
Yeah, it should definitely be interesting to see as teams go here. It looks like we're just settling on sides now, whether it'll be Reunite will be on attack or defense first. We'll find out in a moment, and then we'll be on the way to Hollywood.
I'm trying to look at some of the players on Flat Earth to see if I recognize any familiar names here. We haven't been able to see a lot of them. One of the problems is when some of the newer teams, the new tournaments, we want to follow teams that are somewhat established. So if a team gets knocked out early, we just almost never see them.
Yeah, definitely.
But I think I've played with a couple of guys. Outsider is on Flat Earth. I think Linkser is on Flat Earth. Vaunathil is definitely there. Draxius. So yeah, some familiar names if you've played on any of the EU servers or seen any of our tournaments. Some of these guys are familiar with us. They are sixth in our GOSUGamers.net ranking system right now, fifth in Europe. So a lot of the European teams towards the top of our charts. Of course, with NotEnigma disbanding and having to reform, took a hit in the rankings as well. So they've beaten almost every team they've come up against, except for those upper echelon teams. They're 0-2 against Reunited.gg, and they're 0-2 versus IDDQD. But they're looking to turn that record around against United right now.
Yeah, and really, it can be hard for teams to get over the hump. I mean, this is a different game, but I definitely remember seeing it in Heroes of the Storm quite a bit, where you sort of had your undisputed top tier. For a while, going back to Heroes of the Storm lore, you sort of had your Cloud9 versus Tempo Storm for a really long time, and then you had all the other teams sort of fighting for the other spots. But it was rare for teams to take games off those top teams. I think FPS games have a bit more variation in general in regards to who's going to win on any given week, or at the very least they lend themselves more to that. But it'll be curious to see, if we're going to see that sort of tiering develop in Overwatch where, you know, maybe right now the top tier in EU would be, say, Reunited in G2, and then you'd have the other teams sort of fighting to get over the hump in the third, fourth, fifth, sixth positions in the mid-tier.
We've talked about this too. It's kind of region-specific how those things shake out, because it seems like North America is almost always like one and two teams, and then there's a big divide between everyone else, right? So in this yes. game, it was not Enigma and Hubris, and they were the best, and then a big divide between everyone else. And Heroes of the Storm, you know, Cloud9, Tempo Storm, big divide between everyone else. And those equalize a little bit, whereas Europe is usually like, there's five really good teams, and I don't know who's going to win. And we're seeing the exact same thing play out in Overwatch.
Yeah, I think with Overwatch, though, they're going to get a lot more variability because really the meta is anything but set. Balance changes will almost certainly come on a little bit more regular basis, and people are just going to figure things out as time goes on. Right now, it does seem like we're in a little bit more of a flavor of the month where we're seeing more Genji play. Although, looking back at it, I don't know if Genji has really been Reunited style. When they've done well, they haven't been doing well as a result of Genji play or anything else. Just more standard, fundamental Pharah, McCree, Reaper play coming out of Reunited. Maybe that's changed in the last week, though.
Yeah, we'll see, but they have one of the more stable rosters, one of the more consistent rosters. This team has known each other forever. If you're interested in their history, I do have an interview with them up on Ghost of Gamers somewhere. If you look back and how the team has formed, it's really interesting. And then Valutaya is one of the best McCrees in the game and has been since week one. So his damage output is really going to be something to watch here as Reunited tries to, I believe, defend first.
And it does look like things are working out in that way. One second, we're having some weirdness with the volume here. Trying to bring up the in-game volume, otherwise things are going to be weird in a hurry. So, we are going in the game. This is going to be Flat Earth versus Reunited. Okay, and that's why things are weird. Overwatch itself is just sort of freezing on going in.
Hey, it's beta. So yeah, we are in our round of eight. Or no, we're in our semifinals? I'm so lost.
We are absolutely in the semifinals. This is Reunited versus Flat Earth. The winner might be going on to face G2 in the finals.
Okay. So everything is kind of set up for the storylines we've been talking about today, for G2 to reemerge as one of the top teams, for Reunited to kind of still hold on as one of the top teams, but finally put together a tournament win. So right now, standing in Reunited's way is Team Flat Earth.
Yep, Flat Earth, and interesting team name. Not really sure what the origin is from it, but if we take a look at the Reunited side, as we're saying with defense, we have Winghaven on Reinhardt, Too Easy on Roadhog, Valutaja on McCree, Unfixed on 76, Morte, bring out the Symmetra, and Bromass on Lucio, and let me say, Hex, we're finally going to see some Hog today.
Yeah, Too Easy on Roadhog, I think, is a really great pick. Pairing him with the Reinhardt as well, the Reinhardt's going to put up those shields. Valutaja and Unfixed are just going to sit behind that shield and pelt away with hitscan weapons. The offense is going to consist of a McCree, is going to be R tier. Zenyatta is going to be run by Vonathil. Koa on Lucio. Drakeus on the Reinhardt. And of course, we have a Reaper with Lynx and a Zarya rounding it out with Outsider.
So we're taking a look at the Roadhog's point of view because we have not seen him. Is he going to get the hook on Reinhardt? No, he misses the hook on Reinhardt. And look at the combination shields. Shields on Reinhardt from Zarya and his own shield as well. Both teams trading off kills to begin with. One for one for one for one right now. Both teams at four players as far. So neither team really getting a big advantage early on.
I have no idea what Flat Earth's tank is doing. Dracarius went in, he charged. He got way out of position. He did end up killing a Symmetra there, but he was way out of position. The team can't push without a tank through this choke point.
Yeah, Reinhardt got kind of lost there. I don't know if he got lost or was looking for Adventure 1. And while that happened, Unfixed was able to sort of take advantage and take out two members of the Flat Earth team in the backline. So you see an early hold coming out from Reunited.
This is an aggressive hold, too. It's pretty far forward. It's not the standard spot you would have over the cafe, overlooking the limo. It's much more easily flanked, but I think they feel comfortable enough with their DPS to go up there. Zarya comes in, another tank kind of lone rangering for Flat Earth, but she comes in with R tier with support. Reaper's going up behind this whole group up here.
Yeah, Flat Earth making some good progress with the Zarya, did shield the McCree. Wasn't quite enough to kill the soldier cleanly, but they are on top of the point now. And that Reunited is struggling just a little bit.
Yeah, they got a couple kills to actually clean up that Reinhardt up top too. And now the Lucio all comes in, and that should confirm the point for them.
Yeah, we saw Valutaja trying to sort of do a little bit towards the end. It's not over yet, though. We do see the response coming up for Reunited. Whole Hog is out for Too Easy. He is going to go down, so they're really struggling to stand the point. We might have Attack Visor coming out from 76 here any second as he tries to stand the point. Discord Orb is out. Both teams trading off alts, and point A is about to be capped. And yes, So definitely closely fought there, but Flat Earth was able to make a game of it and start the payload moving on Hollywood.
Yeah, a couple alts almost saved that, though. Whole Hog came in, and he was able to clear the point a little bit too easy on Roadhog. That Whole Hog came in, but then Bromos was a little too patient on the sound barrier, and Bromos died, or rather too easy died before the sound barrier was able to come off. It's one of those problems with the cast time on Lucio, so they weren't able to use those ultimates together correctly to hold the point.
I mean, I know we do see the Genji coming out from Flat Earth as they go into the sixth point. We see Winghaven ready with the Earth Shatters, so expect to see some defensive ults coming out here. They are speed boosting in. Winghaven is looking for the Earth Shatter, but no, he gets Earth Shattered by Drakus first, and he's going to get taken out before being able to do what he wants.
Yeah, Lynx gets in with his Genji, but dies to in pretty quick order. It's a nice switch up there, coming off Reaper, going to Genji in this rooftop section.
Oh,
Genji can really control roofs.
A nice hook coming out from Too Easy there, able to take out the Lucio. So this is going to be a hold for United. And this has been a pretty even game thus far. I mean, even when Reunited has been wiping Flat Earth, it hasn't been quite the clean, like, ridiculous wipes we saw in some of the earlier rounds, so both teams really throwing some good shots at each other here, Hex.
Right, that push definitely stalled out. When the first two deaths on your team are both your supports, you can't do anything but wait for them to come back to life.
Yep. We do see Outsider now. It does have his Graviton Surge at the ready. Ult's definitely in favor of Flat Earth here. We're going to see if they're going to be able to make this happen. Shielding Lucio perhaps a little bit early here. We do see the Zarya flank coming in. This is really weird positioning, Hex.
It's been some strange positioning almost all game. I'd call it unorthodox at the very least, but they do trade out a couple kills. The ultimate comes down from Lucio on both sides.
Yeah, but look at the Transcendence. The Transcendence is doing a lot to mitigate a decent amount of this, but two pickoffs are going to come out here for Flat Earth. Both teams trading off kills. Neither team have big advantage yet. That's going to be another kill coming out for Flat Earth, and this might be what they need to get some serious payload progress.
Yeah, they're going to be able to push the card a little bit. Winghaven with a charge there took the Transcendence ultimate out of the fight, but then himself was out of the fight. It's that weird balance with Reinhardt. If I charge, is it helping my team or hurting my team? Is me being out of this fight enough that I'm taking their hero out of the fight?
Yeah, and taking a look at this, Genji right now just sort of trying to poke, make a little bit of space for the payload. We do see Too Easy coming out the Whole Hog. He's getting taken up very quickly by Artir, and here comes the Dragon Blade coming out from Lynx. Will Lynx be able to get some value? He's not really near a whole lot of members of the team. He's going to fight Volutaha here. Volutaha is going to come out on top, and here comes Volutaha. Brian the flank just a little bit for Reunited.
Yeah, the positioning seems a little bit better now from Flat Earth. They're all a little bit more coordinated, not taking those strange tank angles anymore. The tanks are actually with the team. Too Easy comes in and finds out, yeah, both the tanks are with the team, and he dies very quickly.
Oh.
That's three kills for Flat Earth. They're going to get this point.
And that was uncharacteristic for Volta. Volta usually very shut down and hunting supports, but he just got crunched by Kawa in the corner as Lucio. So, pretty good progress coming from Flat Earth. They're looking much stronger than expected here, I think, Hex.
Yeah, they're putting on a pretty good show so far. I expect a Reunited to hold that first point much longer than they did. Maybe it's because they held a little aggressively there, but right now, some of the alts coming down are just not timed well enough, not coordinated enough. It seems they're a little out of sorts.
Yeah, and really saw McCree actually very far up from over there, going back on the payload now, but really Flat Earth making pretty good progress, pretty good time. They are looking strong right now, and I think Reunited sort of has to regroup and sort of, you know, reestablish their defense here, because I think they've been a bit out of sorts.
Yeah, Lynx playing really well on Genji, wins the Genji one-on-one fight. Transcendence comes in offensively. Valutaya tries to high noon it, gets one kill off, and takes the tank down.
Yeah, and taking a look at Artir right now. Artir getting some good poke down. Both teams sort of, again, trading out. Morte able to take out the Zarya. Neither team, though, really getting a big advantage. But that being said, I think Flat Earth's okay with that because they're still getting progress on the payload.
Yeah, the card has not stopped moving. Now, this last point becomes really hard to push, as most defensive lasts do. The respawn times are very quick. They're going to come out. There's a big flank coming from Lynx maybe up top, though. Transcendence offensively comes in, or defensively, gets pushed out right away.
Yeah, Unfixed, going to be able to pick up kills. Too Easy, slicing and dicing as Genji. Some nice stuff coming up here. That is a 4-kill for Too Easy, if not a 5-kill. So just like that, Genji comes out and absolutely demolishes the Flat Earth team. So we're talking about Reunited needed to sort of reestablish themselves. I think they did that just there.
Yeah, I thought they were really going to go for an aggressive hold there. They boosted in. They had everyone up about ready to spawn camp. Then they thought better of it and pulled back to a more defensive position.
Yep. Taking a look at Too Easy here. Too Easy fighting the Reaper is going to get taken out. That's a really big pick for Flat Earth. And now the sort of the gates are open for Too Earth. They can make something happen with this.
Yeah, Lynx in the back line with that Genji trying to get some work done, causing all sorts of chaos. Drakeus with a huge charge in. He's really holding some presence here, but he needs to get some support.
Oh,
Lynx
and
with a bunch of kills.
So that's almost a full team wipe in favor of Flat Earth, and now really Reunite has to Zerg the point if possible. No, they're not even able to do that. Everyone dies, and that's a pretty fast time coming out for Flat Earth there. It looks like they're saying it's 6:58. We're going to get the true time in a moment, but it's definitely very close to that, if nothing else. But let's take a look at this great Genji play from Too Easy. Too Easy really showing his chops here. Unfortunately, though, Reunite wasn't able to sort of keep up this defensive presence immediately after this, because it was a push right after where Flat Earth was able to come in and win the game.
Yeah, it was a 4K. I think their indecisiveness cost them a little bit there. If you're going to go that far forward and you're going to push the spawn, go ahead and do it. But the fact that they went far forward and then weren't able to retreat as a team kind of hurt them a little bit, too. Their Zenyatta was out of position. Then the Reinhardt was out of position because they were both going for that forward camp, but the rest of the team wasn't there. So as they're falling back, they're kind of in a scattered position, and that allowed the offense to come in, get a couple kills, and just keep that momentum rolling.
Yeah, and looking at this now, we're going to be switching sides, and this is I'd say it's a beatable team or beatable time for Reunited, but it's not an easy time to beat. It's sort of middle of the road. They're going to have to play well if they want to beat this time of 6:58 set by Flat Earth.
Yeah, we've seen Hollywood kind of skew more defensively in recent weeks, and when it first came out, the first point was very difficult to hold, and then we saw Melty make a really good hold on it with Symmetra once, and a lot of teams kind of adopted that style. It's defensible. We've seen teams be stopped at the first point on this map as well. We saw Eccentric stop teams at the first point last week. So it's a map that's a pretty tough time to beat.
Yeah, it'll be interesting. I mean, really, I think Flat Earth, they have to be pretty proud of their time that they just set up on the first side. Again, Reunite, I think, can beat it, but it's going to be tough. If nothing else, I think this could be a map that's going to come down to maybe a, you know, 10-20 second difference between both teams. We could be in for a very, very exciting finish here.
Yeah, now we talk about double Lucio compositions a lot on King's Row and on offense, but right now it looks like Flat Earth wants to run a double Lucio on defense on this map, and I absolutely love it. Lucio is great just as far as spamming very specific chokes and hallways, and Hollywood happens to offer one of the greatest ones right underneath that arch. There's a car there. It's really hard for teams to get through. Tanks can't even go through it 2x2 side by side, so you start spamming down those Lucios, and as I finish this comment, they switch off one of those Lucios. Darn it.
Yeah, I mean, really, they might have just been listening to the cast, even though there is a delay, somehow hearing it in the moment, and they just wanted to make you look bad, Hex. I don't know what to say.
Yeah,
that being
well,
said, let's...
The theory stands. I stand by the double Lucio defense theory.
Taking a look at the Reunited offense, we got Morte on Zenyatta, Valtaha on the McCree, Too Easy as Genji with an orb, Bromass on Lucio, Unfixed on Soldier 76, and Winghaven on the Winston.
Yeah, defensively, they're going to run the Symmetra, and it's really kind of feast or famine. Is she going to be up on time to get the teleporter up? Is the teleporter going to be useful enough? I love that they're running a 76 Outsider on defense, too. He's going to be able to do that long-range poke, hold up some of these high grounds, and of course, you're going to run a Lucio, a Reinhardt. That's Koa and Drakeus. Lynx is going to be on Reaper again.
Yep, so we're taking a look at this as they go forward here, and Too Easy making his way into the backfield, has penetrated it successfully, and he's fighting McCree back and forth here, and really, both teams are sort of poking back and forth, neither team really engaging too hard, but Lynx was able to get the quick defensive pick, and that's going to spell some trouble for Reunited.
Yeah, they conceded this high ground pretty quickly, but Outsider fell back to the cafe, but right now they're so grouped up. If we get some big splash damage up there, it'd be huge, but they're going to push up.
Lynx getting a second pick now, so really it's a 4v6. Too Easy finding himself fighting Lucio in the back, but he's not getting a lot done for what they're anticipating. This not getting the value they need off Genji. R-tier killing two people in the back, so we sort of have this Genji-Lucio duel going back here, but Flat Earth has really done their best to hold on here, and Reunited's gonna have to regroup.
That was phenomenal. I thought they had lost the high ground, and then they just took their Reinhardt and a couple of their pick glasses and just walked up the stairs and pushed them off the roof.
Yeah, I mean, the bigger thing there is that Too Easy got bullied out by a Lucio, and that's not what you want from your Genji play. You need to be a little bit stronger and just take out that support. And oh, Reinhardt with the crunch on Valtaha. Valtaha is going to go down very quickly. Take a look, Too Easy. Too Easy is going to die in the back. And again, Reunited looking a little bit discombobulated here.
Yeah, Drake is playing a really nice Reinhardt right now. He's just not taking no for an answer. He's going wherever he wants. He's dictating the pace of this game.
Yeah, no, some really, really nice play coming off that. That being said, we have a Sound Barrier is going to be up for Reunited in this next push. They're going to use it to push in. We'll see if that'll be the sort of the oomph they need to get through here. But really, you have to be happy thus far if you are Flat Earth, because they're putting up a really nice defensive time here.
Yeah, so far it's been, I think they're about to reach the threshold where it's a better hold than the opposing team was able to put up. So they're going to try a flank. Both High Noons are up.
Yeah, we have a Deadeye coming out right now from Volatile. I think he's going to have to back up and save it. I don't know if he really got what he wanted there. He is able to get this Metro, though, so that works out. Soundbearer coming out, 2EZ and Volatile with picks, respectively. So I think Reunite is going to be able to go through here and grab point A.
These turrets are up and still doing so much work. The teleporter did fall somewhere in there, though.
Yeah, and the teleporter...
No, they're going to hold this. They're going to hold this.
Are they really? Yeah, take a look at that. It was looking really good for them, but I guess with the aid of the teleporter, they're able to come back in. Wow.
Yeah, teleporter died like the beginning of that fight, but I think people had already gotten through. Some of these sentry guns were still up, and they were doing a lot of work, a lot of beams going on the point, and eventually, when you ignore sentry guns like that, or sentry turrets, whatever you want to call them, they will eventually kill you, and they slow you as well.
I'm really surprised. I mean, they got so many picks to begin with there. They just, I guess Reunite was not able to really reestablish on the point. By the way, look at this. Lynx with the Death Blossom. He's going to drop down and rain death from above. He's just looking for the right opportunity. But hang on. Here comes Too Easy. Not wanting to let him get in that easily. I think he should have taken it. I think he had the opportunity.
Yeah, he was a little bit hesitant. Now he's discorded, so he's got to be very careful.
Yeah, the Death Blossom opportunity. I think he wasted it there. He's going to go down without using it at all. And that's a big problem for Flat Earth. And now it's looking like Reunited going to be very, very good on the point. The teleporter still might be up, though, so let's not count things out just yet. Unfixed does build up the Graviton Surge, might drop at any moment. Death Blossom does come in, does not get anywhere near the value that they wanted. But it's still a brawl in the fight, Hex.
Yeah, I really thought that Reunited was going to be able to push that point. The offensive Transcendence came in and was looking really good. But as these reinforcements come in, they're cleaning this up again.
Interesting enough, I think we've just had a case where, like, both teams have been kind of hesitant on using their ults when they should be using them. We do see Too Easy cleaning up in the backfield, so finally, a good Graviton Surge, Dragonblade combo. But I think Graviton Surge could have been used a little bit earlier in that fight to sort of secure the point quicker.
Yeah, regardless, that is a very, very formidable first point defense. That's a lot of time.
Yeah, well, looking at the time that's remaining right now, Reunited only has 3 minutes to bring this limo from here all the way to completion. So they have to go, go, go and not get stopped at all in this next part of Hollywood.
Yeah, that limo's going to slow itself down, too. It turns very slowly. It gets to the point very slowly. So it's going to be a struggle to be able to put enough bodies on this limo to keep it going.
Yeah, and again, it's not possible for Reunited to get win here, but they need to just move and not get stopped at all. Taking a look at Volatile right now. Volatile taking the elevator up. It takes a while for him to create a position like this on this map. This is a bit of an investment, but hopefully it will work out for him. He wants to set up for the aerial advantage to, you know, hopefully set up a better Deadeye.
Yeah, they have been kind of dominating the high ground both on the first point and now on the second point, too. Like you said, getting the McCree up there is tough, and they have to deal with it. Here comes the Deadeye.
Yeah, Deadeye comes out. Morte able to pick off Link, so that's a pickup that he needed. Volta able to drop Fanhammer on Reinhardt, take him out. Too Easy with the pick on the back line, so this is exactly what Reunited needs, Hex, if they want to stay in this game. They know they're behind on time, but if they can get through here quickly without getting wiped, they might be able to even things up.
Yeah, defensively they're bleeding, but they have to be kind of careful because Koa right there, he got caught out of position and he's just trying to distract them. He's just trying to waste their time and they need to kind of figure out if they're going to try to deal with it. Never mind, dealt with.
And Volatile was able to deal with him in short order. And taking a look, Morte is going to have Transcendence up. He will be able to negate a Death Blossom or other offensive thing. And here comes the Transcendence, maybe rushed a little bit there. Both Reinhardts are going to get taken down. Volatile cleaning up the other McCree. This is looking in Reunited's favor, but... And yeah, they are going to take it out. Too Easy doing some work in the backfield.
Yeah, but like you mentioned, that Transcendence is down. It was a Transcendence in response to a Reinhardt charge, which hit the limo. It wasn't a response to an ultimate or anything, which is what you really want to be saving that for.
Yeah, I mean, in the end, it still worked out for them, but I wonder if they're going to regret that as they push forward here, because now they're just not going to have the Transcendence for the next round of ultimates right. Coming out from Flat Earth.
It's one of the most powerful pushing mechanics as well as being a defensive mechanic, so to have to waste it there is actually a small victory for Flat Earth.
Yeah, so Reunited still needs to move here. They only have about a minute left to go through. They do have Dragonblade up. They have Deadeye up. They have most of their ult up, in fact, so their play here is they need to get a big combination between Zarya, Reinhardt, and the Genji, get for a full wipe and just continue pushing, because again, they don't have that much time.
Yeah, they're going to try to keep 3x on this Karpi until they get to the threshold, until the fight is forced upon them.
We have a Genji fight up here. I'm not sure if Too Easy has Norm or not. Graviton surges up for both teams. Both teams getting caught. Dragonblade coming down. Langso able to slice and dice the entirety of the backfield of Reunited, and that could have been game. I think that is game, Hex.
That was just everyone smashed their Q button at once, and Lynx came out on top. Was that a Graviton Surge with that as well?
yeah, both teams had Graviton Surge out there, and Lynx was able to get the follow-up. Too Easy tried to go for the same follow-up, but was a little bit late, and I think that's all the difference in the world, because again, you look at the time, it is going to be GG in 5 seconds. Flat Earth takes it, going up map one over Reunited, so arguably a little bit of an upset here to start off the game, and Reunited is going to have to bring this to three maps if they want to make it to the finals today.
Yeah, that was crazy. Now, in the early phase of beta, we saw Graviton Surge often paired with Aerial Barrage, but we haven't seen a lot of Pharah's. Actually, we've only seen Pharah, I think, once so far today. It's just kind of falling out of the meta. So what we are seeing is that Genji and the Graviton Surge just creates this giant ball of meat for the Genji Dragon Sword, and it's a brutal outcome. That's,
Yep.
Yeah. Wow. Flat Earth.
Flat Earth, I mean, they look strong, and really, it just came down to their point. The difference between the two teams, the point one defense for Flat Earth was just so much better. It bought them a lot of time and just didn't leave Reunited with much time to think about their setup going through the last points here.
Yeah, and we didn't talk a whole lot about that Symmetra, but that's almost the mark of a good Symmetra. She was doing her job and no one really noticed it. The teleporter was up, it did get taken down, but it had to be focused on resources. And then for some reason, they just weren't clearing out those Symmetra turrets. They were slowing, they were doing chip damage, and some people actually died to a few of them. And it also bought them enough time to stall at that point several times over. Drakeus getting the card there. Drakeus played a great Reinhardt that game.
Yeah, no, Drakeus did really, really well. And again, the other thing too is that I'm not sure Reunited really got the most out of their Genji play there. I mean, there is points where... So I think the biggest difference between, say, Reunited and what we saw coming out from G2 earlier is that Shadowburn was absolutely vicious on his Genji play. I mean, he would come in on as Genji, and it didn't matter what he was up against. He would just take it out immediately if it was a support class. Whereas what we saw there is that Too Easy was kind of struggling taking out the Lucios and whatnot, just not quite as crisp. And if you're not getting those clean Genji combos, his effectiveness is a lot worse.
Yeah, we've seen feast and famine on Genjis. If a Genji gets rolling and he's playing well, then the entire team has to focus and try to shut him down. But sometimes if Genji's getting shut down, you really feel that you're down a player because his effectiveness just doesn't scale in the same way that other heroes can be effective while not being ultra effective.
Yeah, definitely. And yeah, I mean, Flat Earth came out and looked really strong. They took map one away from Reunited, and now Reunited finds itself in a situation where it's in a must-win situation for maps two and map three.
Yeah, best of three is not a best of five like the finals are going to be, so it's kind of do or die for Reunited. And, you know, I've written a lot about Reunited, and I've talked a lot about Reunited even when they were Fnatic, but this is one of the things I talk about is they can beat absolutely any team in the scene. But they could lose to almost about anyone in the scene, too. So the consistency, they're always consistently up there. They're in quarters, they're in semis, but they need to find a way to take these final steps to become a top team.
Yeah, definitely. And again, Reunited definitely has it in them to bring this series back. They are a very experienced team, but they got rattled, and Flat Earth looking very, very strong. Actually, some commentary from chat saying Flat Earth, their core team, I guess, was one of the top teams in Dirty Bomb. So maybe they just need a little bit of time to sort of adapt to the differences in Overwatch and bring their team experience here. Shout out to Fish Sticks for coming with that little bit of knowledge. I definitely did not know that coming into this.
Yeah, so with Twitch chat, if you guys know stuff about these teams that we don't know, I'm more than happy to learn. A lot of these teams like have histories. A lot of people in Twitch chat have played with some of these guys. Shout that out. Tweet at us. Hit us all up with that information. We'll gladly include it in the cast. But yeah, that's interesting. Dirty Bomb has payload mechanics as well. So it just took them a little bit to adjust those payloads to this payload's mechanics. I was really impressed with Drakeus there. That's how you play Reinhardt. You don't sit back. You don't go on your heels. Yep. You push forward. And he took control of that match in several different instances.
So looking at the draft right now, we see Reunited not really changing the draft strategy at all. They are taking out Nippon Li Zhang. They do not want to be brought to King of the Hill. That is not a very game mode that they are very fond of 2 weeks in a row now. And Flat Earth, they took out Hollywood, which is interesting because they just won on Hollywood. Maybe they thought it was a little bit too close for comfort. I don't know. But Flat Earth not wanting to go back to the map that they won on. And we're going to be going to a new map here regardless, X, because Dorado and Nambani are both on the table.
Excellent. I like both of these maps, and I think they both play to different strengths that each of these teams have. So once we finalize the map, and it is going to be Nambani.
Going to Nambani. Nambani's awesome. I mean, definitely one of my favorite maps in Beta 1, and still a pretty cool map to watch in Beta 2. I feel like you get a lot of cool defensive positioning play on the point, And then there's a lot of options for dealing with the payload phase in terms of flanking, how to set up. You do see Widowmaker here more often than other maps. I think you just get good variety in general in Nambani. I think it's a well-balanced map.
Yeah, definitely you're going to see hero variety. It's going to be interesting to see if we see a Symmetra run up here. It's a good Symmetra map. Get the teleporter up. 76 is really good on this map because of those perches that overlook Final Point. We've even seen a Bastion on this map, so we can see anything.
Yeah, I don't know if we're going to see the Bastion here today. I mean, that nerf was not particularly kind to him. I think even though he got maybe a little bit extra on the offensive end, his ability to actually take damage is just in the toilet now compared to where it was. He lost a whopping 300 health, and that is hard to replace, X.
Yeah, all the players who are playing pubs are just smiling right now and just clapping. Thank God he lost that health. But in competitive play, he was already struggling to see play. We saw him pocketed with a Mercy and still get focused on really, really easily. I think at higher levels of play, when mobility becomes such a big part of the game, which is why Genji is so popular, that characters who have that very low mobility and that static mobility really are just going to struggle.
Yeah, definitely. So both teams are ready. Casters are ready. We're going to be getting into Nambani any second now. And we'll see just what Reunited is going to bring out here if they want to stay alive in this tournament.
Yeah, I was doing rankings again this week, and I had Reunited, and I like the guys. I've spoken to these guys, they're good guys. I think they are going to be a successful team overall, but I had to rank Reunited even after last week at, I think I have them 4 or 5, and I want to put them higher. They've shown that they can do good things, they can beat good teams, but the consistency isn't there, and there's often times in tournaments where they're losing to, I don't want to say lesser teams, but teams that I think they should beat.
Yeah, I mean, consistency is a key point, right? Is that Reunited has shown that they do have a very high ceiling at points, but they've also shown that their floor can go lower than it probably should be in terms of, you know, actually getting good results against teams they probably should be beating. Not saying that they should be beating Flat Earth. Flat Earth has looked very, very good this far, but Reunited just has to bring their consistency up to a different level than what they've been bringing thus far.
Yeah, and it's going to have to start on Nambani here. They are going to be playing defense on Nambani first, and I think we are going to see that Symmetra.
Yep, they like running the Symmetra. I mean, it's sort of been a hallmark of theirs for a while now, whether it's taken from Meltier or not, who knows. But looking at the defensive lineup for Reunite, we got Winghaven on Winston, Too Easy on Reaper, Volataha on McCree, Morte on the Symmetra, Bromass on Lucio, and Unfixed on Zarya. And of note, no Genji right now for either team.
Yeah, a little bit surprising. I do love the Symmetra on this map. So many good spots for her to set up, and getting that teleporter up, negating that long walk to reinforce the first point is huge. On offense, they're going to run a Zarya. That's going to be Outsider. Artier is going to run the McCree for them. They're going to see a Mercy. That's going to be Vonathil. Koa is going to be Lucio. Drakeus is going to be on Winston. And Lynx, we get to see some Pharah today. Lynx playing Pharah.
Yep, so Pharah, actually, we've seen a lot less of her today, if you think about it, just compared to what we've seen in the past in Beta 1 or even early in Beta 2. I'm not sure if she's falling out of favor or what, but we get to see everyone's favorite Rocket Queen in this game of Nambani.
Yeah, I think part of the problem is there's a lot of really good McCrees and Soldier 76s, and that's hell for Pharah.
Yeah, and Volatile is getting out McCreed right now by Artier, and this could be what Flat Earth needs, to just rush a point, and they have 2 picks down right now, 3 picks, and this is looking very good for them.
Yeah, Dracaeus not on Reinhardt, but still dictating the pace. His Winston is super aggressive. I love how he's playing tank this game.
Now we see Reunite coming back a little bit, though, able to get 2 picks off their own. It is a bit of a brawl remaining on the fight. Winston going to pick off the final part, and while it was looking good for a Flat Earth to start with, we might see a Reunited hold here.
Yeah, I did like what Flat Earth did, though. They tried to get through both of these rooms because they knew there was a Symmetra up, so they were trying to find the teleporter so that the next wave could be a more successful attack.
Yeah, taking a look at it. So Reunite is able to hold, and really, even though that was looking so good for Flat Earth to begin with, they weren't even able to get a single third of the point, so that was a very nice hold in the Embarrassing Reunite. And we're seeing this back and forth on both maps here, where both teams are very evenly matched. It's hard to call these fights in the very beginning.
Yeah, teleporter back up. These Symmetra turrets are going to end up doing a lot of work because they have to be ignored in the beginning parts of these fights. The flank coming in, they're all a little grouped up, and this defense is holding really strong.
Yeah, we saw Winston pop Primal Age pretty early there for Flat Earth. Not really the most effective as it was. He still ended up getting taken out by multiple Fan the Hammers coming from Volataha. And just like that, that's going to be another full wipe in favor of Reunited. So Reunited, a little bit stronger this map. I think more in their comfort zone for one reason or another. But Flat Earth really needs to figure out something to change here if they want to take point A.
I think we're going to see one more push based on the fact that they have ultimates up. We're going to see a Mercy Resurrection, an Aerial Barrage is going to try to come down somewhere, and then if that fails, I think we're going to see Hero Switches.
Yep. We do see the Deadeye coming up from Volatile. Volatile is able to take out Mercy, and look at Too Easy picking off the double kill in the back. Lynx is still up, but he doesn't really have much of a team left. He's sort of fair without any sort of support, and he's just going to try and get away and not stagger deaths as much.
Yeah, he does get away, and I think he just, well, no, he actually is cleaned up towards the end there. Not able to get the ultimate off. None of the ultimates were actually cast there for Flat Earth.
Yeah, and I'm getting a note here. We still have some nice defensive ultimates up for the Reunited side. Too Easy holding on the Death Blossom. He's going to be looking for a drop down here to be sure. We'll see if he's going to be able to get it, but, you know, looking at the time here, there's only 2 minutes and 15 seconds left for Flat Earth to even continue the map, so this is not... Oh, look! Out comes the Death Blossom. Not quite as effective as it could have been. Nice Winter Shield to take out most of it, but enough damage was done. Too Easy picks up the triple kill.
But here's Barrage, the Wes comes down, though. Beautiful.
Yeah. The Wes in the Barrage. This might turn it in favor of Flat Earth, even though that was a nice opening from Reunited.
The teleporter just came up, though, so there is going to be reinforcements, and they're flooding in through this back room. An instant teleporter. They got 4 back on the point now because of that.
Yeah, taking a look at R-Tier. R-Tier is right now trying to clean this point up for the Flat Earth side, but it is an actual brawl. Both teams flooding on top of the point. As you mentioned, the reinforcements coming from the teleporter. Too Easy back in the fray. Hellfire shotguns doing work. Both teams fighting, and it's not super clear who's going to take this X.
No, it's getting really scrappy, but if I had to give the advantage, it's got to be to Reunited right now. That teleporter was so clutch. It went up the fight was beginning, and it brought everyone back in the fight. You saw people just blinking in. The teleporter is now actually out of charges. That's how often it was used during that fight.
And also, you want to know, talk about a switch up there just to sort of get more presence on the point. Volatile, after dying, did a switch up to Winston, and it worked out really, really well. He was able to stand the point and actually get 3 kills, I think, as Winston. So some nice situational switching coming out from Reunited there.
Yeah, and again, that plays in with the fact that they had the teleporter up, that he can be there right away with a Winston and reinforce, and they're selling out to hold this defense. They're not going to concede it and just move on and play defense as the payload starts moving. They want to hold this by squadooshing them.
Yep, and taking a look here, we do have Rez back up. Rez charging very quickly. Drakeus has Earth Shatter up, so this is kind of do or die now for Flat Earth. If they want to put up a better effort on the money, Volatile and Outsider ending up trading back here. Earth Shatter comes down. Is he going to be able to crunch? No! He does not take out the Reaper, and that is unfortunate because the Death Blossom is able to take out Lynx, and now both teams trading off deaths back and forth here, but it's looking like it's going to be in favor of Reunited yet again, Hex.
Yeah, only Lucio up on the point is the last one to fall. They're going to run a Tracer here to try to put some pressure on it, try to get there. It's a pretty long walk to this point, but I think that's going to spell the end of this defense successful by Reunited GG.
Yeah, Lynx... Oh, Lynx did trigger the overtime. He got on there just in time. Mercy going to throw her body on the trigger. They are staggering deaths now, and a last-ditch attempt to stay on here. Deadeye coming out from R tier. He is getting knocked all sorts of around. Morte with the double kill on Symmetra, and that is going to be it, and almost certainly as Reinhardt goes down. Reunited with a very, very impressive stage one on the Mbani.
Yeah, that Symmetra play overall was what really turned the tides of that defense. When it started looking like Flat Earth was getting a little bit of momentum, they got a couple good kills. They got the Resurrection off in the Barrage. Immediately following the Resurrection and the Barrage, which should have been the point for Flat Earth, that teleporter came up 100%, and they reinforced 4 to 5 people in a moment's notice.
Yep. So, again, here, play of the game coming out here from Too Easy. Too Easy had some pretty good Death Blossoms this game, and this wasn't even a Death Blossom. This was just, hey, you're all going to be stuck in the Graviton Surge. Let me just shoot my shotgun over and over again.
Too Easy.
See what you did there, Hex.
Yeah, it's clever.
I'll give you some props.
It's not clever at all, but I'll take it.
Yeah, so we are going into the next set of Mbani. There will be no timer here. All that is needed for Reunited to even up the series 1-1. Is all they have is capturing point A on Mbani.
Yeah, that seems like a map they're very comfortable on. I think the Symmetra, we've seen Symmetra really kind of establish herself in the meta. She used to be a niche pick, right? Only Bod was running her on Melty, running her very well, but I think teams took notice and said, if we can support the Symmetra long enough to get her at peak effectiveness, then she's going to win us games. The slowing on the turrets, the turret overall just being a nuisance that you have to waste bullets on, and what it feels like is that you're wasting bullets, and then getting the teleporter up, that it was as good, if not better, than a Resurrection was.
Yeah, no, it was, I'd say it was better because the way the res is right now, you're not going to get the full team reses quite as often. So I'd say in terms of getting a team back in the point, a teleporter often can provide a little bit more value. Obviously, it depends on what's going down, but a teleporter doesn't quite have the same opportunity for the other team to sort of layer on a Deadeye or some other alt to sort of get all the newly resing people in another death trap.
Yeah, you get to choose the positioning of a teleporter, and positioning the resurrection often just brings your team back into the hands of death. So yeah, really, really good Symmetra play there. I liked it. And it looks like Flat Earth's going to take a page out of that book and run their own Symmetra on defense.
Yeah, looking at the offense here, since I don't think they're really going to be running a change shenanigans here, looking at Reunited, they are going to be running the Genji Zenyatta again. Morte on the Zenyatta, too easy on the Genji. Backing it up with Valta on McCree, Unfixed on Zarya, Bromass on Lucio, and Winghaven on Winston. So we didn't see the Genji coming out for Flat Earth in the last game, but looks like we're going to be seeing the Genji coming out for Reunited here.
Yeah, it's interesting how you see different synergies of heroes working out in like kind of squad-based play. Of course, the Zenyatta is going to orb the Genji, but then the Genji's also going to get the shield from the Zarya, so he's just going to go off on his own. And then what you're going to see is Lucio is going to hang out with both the tanks. They're going to try to push in as quickly as possible. Winston's going to drop down that barrier, and Valutaj is going to shoot people through it. So it's just the synergy of all these heroes is what makes these compositions work so well together.
Yep. So taking a look at this here, we're going to be following Genji's point of view to begin with. He does have that orb, and will too easy be able to have a little bit more effectiveness as Genji this time. We saw on Hollywood that he had some issues getting the picks on the support heroes that he wanted to get. Lucio definitely proving to be somewhat of an issue with him. I'm not sure if that was too easy playing perhaps a little bit poorly in that particular instance, or Lucio playing really well. Probably a mix of both. Right. But they're going to need a little bit more contribution from Genji this time.
Symmetra's actually a pretty good counter to Genji too, and I also like the Roadhog pick into it.
Oh, Taj, wow.
Two quick kills.
That was some great play coming from Valta. Too easy on the pickup here, and this might be over before it even begins. So many people are already down for the Flat Earth team. I can't imagine how they make this here. Look at the teleporter. The teleporter is already up, but the teleporter is already down. I can't believe Symmetra built teleporter that early, to be honest.
That was impressive, actually. I didn't think there would be any chance that teleporter was up, but what just happened?
I mean, Valta got those very quick McCree picks. He was on point, and just like that, we're going to game number three, Hex.
Well, it appears that Reunited GG is good on Nubani. It appears that that's the case.
They seem much more comfortable in Nubani than they did in Hollywood. Let me tell you that, Hex.
Oh, I just...
But, I mean, you blink and you missed it. That was a great stage from Reunited.
Yeah, I don't even think it was really anything that Flat Earth did wrong. It was, I guess, you know... Man, these like the last two maps are just Reunited in a nutshell, right? They can do that on this map. What they can do that to any team in the game, and then they can lose to any team in the game. It's just insane.
Yeah, it just comes back to, again, we talk about Reunited. They are probably the most inconsistent team in the game. Their ceiling very high, their floor very low. So they, you know, I'm trying to think of a proper like sports analogy for. I can't think of one for European football though. Maybe I can think of some for. American football, where it's just, you know, you have a team where they do really great things, but then they just disappoint you when you want them to impress you the most. I feel like Reunited is kind of like in that tier now. Like, I don't know, Hex.
I mean, I've mentioned in some other things I've written, they're so exciting and fun to watch and so frustrating to watch too, because they're so close to just being a really, really dominant team. And for some reason, there's something missing. There's something that just doesn't click on some maps. I don't know if it's map selection, hero selection. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, I mean, again, maybe they're just missing a piece or two there that they need to refine, and then everything will click and it'll be good. But I mean, how else do you explain sort of the disconnect we saw between map one and map two there, where they looked positively out of sorts on Hollywood, their offense being weird, their defense not being the greatest, and then they come out on Nubani, hold on the first point, and then just absolutely blitz the first point in their attacking run and take it? I mean, it's such a difference between map one and map two that I don't even think we see the sort of variation coming out from other teams.
Right. In a vacuum, you could just say that it's like, oh, they're better on Nubani than they are in Hollywood. But it's been a trend and a pattern with Fnatic now Reunited. So if anything, it makes a very interesting story to follow as a team.
Yeah, I mean, it's just one of those things where you want to get consistency over time. You don't want to drop games you shouldn't drop, but, and hopefully for them, they will get that consistency as time goes on. So right now we are are waiting for the next map draft. We'll see what we're bringing you to. I think it's safe to say that Flat Earth is not going to be going back to Numbani.
I predict that as well. We know Reunited doesn't love King of the Hill, but we also know that no one loves control point maps. So we could be seeing a Dorado. We could be seeing a King's Row. Yeah, man, it's wide open, but I still can't believe how fast they took that Numbani point. That was insane. That was a first push. That was, you know, hit it out of the park. They're betting 1,000 there.
Yeah, I mean, they had a really good defensive hold, and then they took it on the very first push, as you mentioned, and good for them that they did, because look at how quickly Symmetra built that teleporter. I mean, she ended up doing a sort of emergency teleporter to try and, you know, throw out a Hail Mary to get back onto the point, but it was just surprising because they got wiped so quickly, and then there it is, the Symmetra teleporter already out.
Yeah, so it's almost the difference of like 10 seconds. If they could have staggered a couple kills in there, get that teleporter up, they probably could have held that point for how quickly that tele came up, but... And it just shows you the relentless onslaught that happened. They weren't able to even get any teleports through that teleporter because it got picked off because the whole team was there.
Yeah, definitely. So right now we are just waiting for the draft link. I think maybe we had an AFK on one of the two teams. I'm not sure. We will not be taking a break here. We will be waiting for the draft and then bring it straight to you for the third and definitive map of Flat Earth versus Reunited.
Yeah, thanks everyone for joining us on our GG Gosu Gamers Weekly EU Cup. As the title denotes, we do these weekly. We'll be doing NA tomorrow. You and I are casting a bunch of Overwatch again tonight and again tomorrow morning. You can find those, I'm sure, everywhere else. There's Overwatch all weekend, and I could not be happier about it. So, and also a big shout out while we have a moment to our sponsors. We got Matcharino.com joining us as sponsors. They're looking into some really cool tournament organization and crowdsourcing for the esports scene, growing that. We've got DX Racer now with us, making quality chairs for your gaming pleasure. And of course, Rock Hat. You can't sit in front of not mouse and not a keyboard. So Rock Hat making your desk look nicer with mice and keyboards. Thanks to all of them sponsoring our tournaments as we go forward. It's been a pleasure to work with them all.
Absolutely. So now we're looking at the next draft here. It is going to be the third and final map. We're going to have Flat Earth with the first ban. Should probably let them know the casters are ready, and we are going to be getting going in just a moment here. So what can we really expect here, Hex? We know that Flat Earth is going to be taking out Numbani probably with first ban. They don't want to go back there. Reunited probably has not rethought their King of the Hill strategy, so King of the Hill is going to go down. And control points are going to go down.
Yeah,
what map do we end up on?
Well, I honestly don't know what maps Reunited played earlier. I wonder if they're ready to go back to King of the Hill, maybe give that a shot. I think we are going to go to Dorado is my gut instinct. One, because my heart hopes for it. And two, because I think that it's a pretty even map that no one has strong feelings about one way or the other. I've not really run into a team that hates Dorado.
Yeah, Dorado, I mean, how can you hate Dorado? It's such a great map. It has so many different opportunities for people to flank and do all sorts of, like, cool things. It's relatively well-balanced. I mean, as you say, no one...
I think it's the best last design point in the game as far as defense and offense having kind of equal opportunities, still the defender's advantage. As far as payload maps go, I think it's the best last point in the game.
So this is a little bit surprising. Numbani's still up. Okay, Flat Earth is going to take it out. They banned Hollywood before Numbani, which is... a little bit weird to me since I won on Hollywood and lost in Numbani, but I guess it doesn't matter. They had both in their sights anyways, and Dorado, Gibraltar, and King's Row remain.
Yeah, we're definitely going to payload. So Gibraltar we saw earlier with G2. It can be a very one-sided affair. King's Row we've seen be very close and very one-sided depending on the teams playing. So we're either going to King's Row or Dorado as Gibraltar gets banned out.
I think Dorado's going to get banned or King's Row. King's Row is more of a comfort map for Reunited. I might be wrong. Maybe they'll bring it to Dorado, but I think going off their ban history in the past, I think they're a little bit more comfortable in King's Row.
Yeah, King's Row is probably a map that they've practiced a lot on, too. In some of our very first tournaments, they got beat pretty decisively by Melty on King's Row a few times, so I'd imagine that lights the fire to put in a lot of practice hours on King's Row. And King's Row just being a staple of a map that we always know you're going to, but I am clairvoyant, and we're going to Dorado.
Yeah, so that's a little bit interesting because Reunited did seem to favor King's Row in the past, but, you know, times do change. People find out that they're better at things than they might have realized, and Dorado is going to be the map.
Excellent. Pinatas, music, beautiful last point. Great map. I'm excited.
Yeah, and we're seeing if sides are final now before we get in to the final point here. Again, this is going to be Dorado. This is Flat Earth versus Reunited. This is map number 3, so both teams throwing their best shots at each other. Reunited coming out a little bit limp out of the gate, but definitely much, much stronger on map 2.
Yeah, it might just be Hollywood's map that they just really don't like. They really looked out of sorts. A lot of just strange tactics weren't working out well for them. But Numbani, the complete opposite. Again, it's just Reunited all over. So we'll see what map 3 takes them. I'm going to try to take a look at the bracket at one point.
So right now we're just seeing if everything is final. But yeah, so Dorado's coming out again. Dorado, we were just talking about it. A map that, generally speaking, I don't think any team really dislikes. It's a fun map. I know for me, it's one of my favorite maps in pubs. It just, it's one of the most, it's either the newest payload map or it's one of the newer payload maps in any case. And it really does show because I think the Overwatch map team has just gotten better and better as time has gone on at designing these maps.
Yeah, as far as hero diversity, I struggle to find a hero who does poorly on Dorado. It seems like everyone's got an angle. Everyone's got an area that they could excel in if they wanted to. There's some maps that I refuse to play certain heroes on because I just don't think they're good enough on it. Dorado's not one of those. Dorado, you can play pretty much any hero at any stage of the entire map.
Yeah, definitely. So, see, right now we're just waiting as teams figure out the sides here. It looks like both teams are in fact ready. So we're going on to map 3. Wait. We don't have Hex in here yet. We're getting Hex in here.
My abandonment issues were totally well-founded.
Yeah, I mean, they're not wrong.
Not wrong. Which is almost better than being right.
Just a bit.
Now all right,
so Hex is in. Now we're ready.
Now the show can proceed.
Indeed. I mean, one of these days it's going to happen where you are just going to get left behind. It's going to be like, well, guys, we got to remake.
You know what? I'm not even going to mention it either. I'm just going to go off whatever you're calling, and I'm going to make my own points, and I'm going to see if anyone even notices.
What if they don't notice? Yeah, how would you feel about that?
Beta. I'm just listening to your calls and speculating. People don't know that.
And finally, the truth comes out.
I'm watching the stream and calling it from the stream. It's crazy. The life I live.
Yep, so Reunited versus Flat Earth, again, 1-1. This is the final definitive map number 3. And Hex, who do you think is going to take this? I mean, I guess it really depends what Reunited are we going to get. Are we going to get the good Reunited or the bad Reunited?
I mean, that's exactly what I'm going to say. I honestly don't know. I think Reunited could easily win it. I think Reunited could easily lose it. I'm still on the camp. They haven't lost me yet. I'm rooting for Reunited. I think they could win it and then they move on to the finals and maybe take the spot that we all think they're capable of taking. But well, I mean, that Hollywood play from Flat Earth was so good that it's going to be hard to beat.
I'll say this for both teams right here. I feel like G2 is operating on a slightly higher level than either of the two teams we've seen here today. Again, it's hard to tell because in FPS games, how you look kind of depends on your competition. So maybe it's a little bit premature, but I think whichever team wins here is definitely going to have their hands full of G2 in the next round. That being said, look at the offense here coming up from Reunited. We have Morte on Zenyatta, Too Easy on the Widow, Valtaha on McCree, Unfixed on Zarya, Bromass on Lucio, and Winghaven on the Reinhardt.
Yeah, defensively, they are going to run a Genji. That's going to be Lynx. Drakeus is going to run his Reinhardt really well on that. Outsider is going to be on 76, Vaunathale on Zenyatta, Artier on McCree, and Kawa rounding it out is Lucio.
Yep, so taking a look at Too Easy's point of view here, will he be able to get the picks? I feel like this is one of the more exciting things in the beginning of the game is, what is Widow going to do? Because if she gets the first blood and gets those picks, it's so definitive for the upcoming push. Too Easy, though, messing up his grapple, not able to get the position he wants. Now, instead of widowing from the top, he's going to have to widow from the bottom.
Yeah,
maybe it'll matter, maybe not.
Lynx above on this Genji, unspotted, gets behind the whole team, takes out Valutaya.
Yeah, and Valutaya going down is a big deal. Valutaya, one of Reunited's big guns, and this is just not at all how they want to start that. We do get the Too Easy pick on our tier. Both teams sort of trading kills, but when it comes to stalling out, it's usually in favor of the defense.
Yeah, but you don't really want to trade on defense here because the walk is so long. You would like to just stay alive, really, in an ideal world.
Yeah, and it looks like even with those trades, it appears that we're going to have Flat Earth defending a little bit further back. And Too Easy finally getting the groove once I stop observing him. He takes out both 76 and Lucio, so a little bit better play coming out from here. And Zarya able to rush down the Genji. Some nice stuff coming out from Unfixed. And just like that, Reunited is sort of changing the flow of the game in their favor.
Yeah, Zarya, of course, a really nice counter to that Genji because her weapon is channeled. It cannot be reflected back at her primary anyway.
Yep, and she's going to have Graviton Surge up now soon, so this is a really nice position for Unfixed. They're able to sort of roll to the next checkpoint after a somewhat questionable beginning.
Too easy with another pick, takes down the Zenyatta. That's a huge pick.
Yep, and right now you just see Unfixed being pretty greedy here. He wants to get the extra charge for Graviton Surge. He knows if he can land a good ult here, it could be just what they need to just move on to the next point.
Lynx gets behind and single targets out too easy as quickly as possible.
But little did he know that Zarya was flanking him. Graviton Surge comes down. I'm not sure if they have the follow-up for it, though. Vonathel and Arts here taking out two people on the Reunited team. And this is not quite working out how they wanted it to go.
Now, a pretty solid defensive follow-up, actually. Both of the teams casted Sound Barrier, so everyone's at full health. But then we had a defensive Earth Shatter come down, and both the tanks just took that point.
Yeah, and we see the Winston Reinhardt tank combination coming out. And this is going to help Flat Earth just solidify a little bit here. And take a note, Lynx does have Dragon Blade up, so it might be coming out any second now. He's not really in position to use it just yet, and the... Oh, Winghaven with a nice Earth Shatter. Knocks down three people. Unfixed and Winghaven with a pair of kills each. Here comes Genji, though. Lynx, though, has to be careful. Zarya's really been working him today.
Yeah, but beyond that, Winghaven took the Zenyatta all the way out of the fight while he was casting Transcendence. Winghaven got himself out of position, then got back in the fight. And look how far back he's pushed this line.
I'm going to note, by the way, we had to switch up from 2EZ. 2EZ now on Tracer. So... See if what he does in Tracer. He already has Pulse Bomb charged up. They're pushing way far up. They're getting very good push on the cart now. And really, Reunited has been in the driver's seat. So thus far, it looks like we've gotten the good Reunited versus the more inconsistent Reunited.
Yeah,
thus far.
Was all Winghaven.
Oh, and he gets the stick
it.
On Lucio. Both Lucio and McCree getting blown up. And look at Winghaven with the charge and Drakias. Is he going to take him out? He's swinging the hammer, but no, he's going to have to back out. Orb's not going in his favor.
Yeah, Orb of Discord melts a tank, but... Too easy has been getting all the kills, but earlier Winghaven just totally renegotiated where the fight was going to take place, and that's why the cart is as far up as it is.
And again, we do see the Graviton Surge coming out. It pulls Reinhardt in there, Tracer flanking from behind. Will they get the kills they need off it? So far, they've got nothing. It's getting mitigated by Transcendence, and Arts here able to take out Too Easy, and here comes Flat Earth.
A really nice Transcendence. We might see dueling sound barriers. We were going to until Bromos died. Another kill goes on to Unfixed as well. And so now the offense is bleeding a little bit, and this cart did not hit the point.
So I think what might have been a mistake on the Reunite point is that it did seem like they had controlled the area for a long time, but they had so many people focused on keeping the area clean that they only had one person pushing the cart. And I think they might be regretting that a little bit right now, because for how much damage they had, I feel like they should have been able to get to the next checkpoint, but Flat Earth doing a phenomenal job of holding it in here.
They do have all their pushing ultimates up, though. We've got Sound Barrier, we've got Transcendence, and Earth Shatter. There are some defensive ones up, but this might favor the offensive timing for a push.
Now, watching Lynx here, Lynx just holding on for the Dragon Blade. And here he comes.
Well, the Transcendence did go off a little early. Sound Barriers are going to come off on both sides. Huge Earth Shatter by Drakeas hits four.
Yeah, and we just see here, this is a go signal for Flat Earth. They are rushing it down. Lynx is able to take out the Zenyatta. That is three people down, but here they come back. Winghaven Too Easy picking off a pair of kills towards the end here, but it's not going to be enough. They're just going to have to reset on their offense. So a nice defensive showing yet again from Flat Earth.
Yeah, a little unfortunate how timed that Genji ultimate was, but the Genji ultimate, I think, might have even forced that Transcendence too. So forcing an ultimate is fine. Too Easy has to be a little bit careful. He is Discorded, so the team has eyes on him, and he is taking extra damage.
Yeah, I mean, one thing I want to note here, by the way, is that unlike sort of the games of G2, Genji has been a factor in these games, but he hasn't been the primary factor. Like, he's been a contributor rather than the uber superstar. I don't know if that's on the Genji players themselves or if both teams are just dealing with Genji a little bit better than the games we saw on the G2 side of the bracket.
Right, that might change now that Lynx took down the opposing Genji, so now he has really nothing to worry about. Free Reign has both orbs on him, though, the healing kind of negated by the Discord orb.
Yeah, and again, Flat Earth able to push out Reunited. So Reunited is... sort of having some struggles here with their offense. They start out really, really well, and now they're just, again, struggling to find their footing.
No, I think you're absolutely right when they missed their window. They had a huge push, and that was the Winghaven push I was talking about. He took the Transcendence out of the fight, and they had the entire area clear, but not enough bodies on the cart.
Yeah, and again, taking a look at Volta. Volta trying to push up. Lynx, though, with the pair of kills coming out, takes up both Zenyatta and Lucio. So, oh, here comes the Earth Shatter from Drakeas. They want to wipe out the remainder of the Reunited team, and they're going to do just that, Hex.
Yeah, that is a lot of deaths right there, and it's almost like a spawn camp, really. And of course, spawns didn't change over here. I'm not sure how the whole team decided to push there. I guess after pushing through the arch a couple times and having no success with it, they decided to try a different angle.
Take a look at Lynx here. Lynx is hiding in the bushes. He is being uber, uber sneaky over here. That's what CK Mori runs afoul of Volta, has a Discord Orb. So now he's going to have to back out. He does not want to drop his ult under these circumstances.
No, and almost all the ults are up for the defensive team right now, except for Earthshatter, but that is one of the crucial ones.
Ults are up for both teams here, really. You see a Graviton Surge coming down. I'm not sure if it grabbed as many people as would have liked. An Art here with a huge Deadeye picks off three people. It was High Noon. Picks up the fourth with Fanning the Hammer. Will he get the fifth? Unfixed in a very precarious position, and he is going to go down. Nice ultimates coming out from Flat Earth and Arts here. Man, that I think that had to be play of the game.
You would think, yeah. In the mess of ultimates and the negation of ultimate to ultimate, it appears that Deadeye still reigns supreme.
Not the too easy, but still get pick on Lynx here. Here comes Reunited. I think they need to take advantage of this. Try and go for the 6v5 here very quickly and do it. And that's exactly what they're doing. They're going in. Dragonblade is down. They want to rush this down while they're down the Genji. I think they're doing just that. Winghaven with a great charge. Volatile making stuff happen. And this is what Reunited, I think, needed to bring the cart to the last point.
Yeah, we saw even with the charge missing, he repositioned so well that they had to turn and try to fight him. He's got the Discord on him, so he looks like an easy target to kill. So people going after Winghaven there, but the charge not hitting anyone, still reposition the fight, and it looks like they're finally going to get this cart to the point with only 10 seconds to spare.
Yeah, I mean, they've bought themselves another 2 minutes here, but 2 minutes is not that long to get through this last point. Getting through this last point can be very, very difficult.
I got a close right here. We got High Noons up for both. Deadeyes, more accurately stated. So we'll see if they can combo those with anything. Earthshatter is up on both sides as well. Earthshatter and Deadeye is a devastating combo.
Yeah, and again, we're just going to see how Flat Earth decides to defend this. They don't really have that much further to go. If they can hold here and not let them complete the map, it would be huge, but they still need to do it. We do see an Earthshatter coming down. Our tier goes down to Winston. We see Drakeus picking up a pair of kills himself. Both teams are trading off kills here, though, and Reunited on the winning side of things. We see Volatile chasing down the Lucio. Not able to kill him just yet. A little bit difficult. And Kawa actually taking down Volatile. Do not see that all that often. Some nice Lucio play coming out from Kawa.
This is one section of the map, though, that it's absolutely fine to trade for defense. Not trading too much, but if you have to go one for one in a fight and that's your only option, it's fine because your respawn times are there and you're in very close proximity to the payload.
Yep. That being said, the Reunite push is pretty good here, and they do have ultimates up. They have Primal Rage. There goes the Primal Rage. Bromass is going to be dropping the Sound Barrier any second now, and Reunited wants to win this right here, right now, Hex.
Yeah, all game we've seen break it downs come on both sides at the exact same time. Arch here with a couple kills. Lynx actually adds another in as well, and this might be the push they're looking for.
Yeah, well, Lynx, this is the defensive hold perhaps they're looking for, as Lynx is able to take out several people with the help of Artyr. Artyr and Lynx acting as the Bash Brothers for Flat Earth, and now Reunited is going to have to hope for a miracle overtime push if they want to complete Dorado in map number 3.
Yeah, Flat Earth getting a little aggressive, holding a little far forward now, but they've got the classes to do it and be able to fall back. We saw Lynx holding forward. He can always just reflect, and he's getting healed, so they're kind of just want to keep eyes on them, make sure they're not going to take a strange path to the cart that they're not anticipating.
Yeah, again, taking a look at this as it goes forward. This is Reunited's last chance. Bromass takes out Artyr. That's a big deal. Artyr has been so good on the defensive end, so they need to push this right now. We do see Genji ult coming out from, I believe, Too Easy. Too Easy trying to slice and dice here, not getting the kills he needs to get. Both teams back in full strength, but no, Volataha picking up a pair of kills. Bromass taking out Drakeus. Lynx, though, in the back. Will he be able to take out enough? But no, he goes down. Reunited taking out the vast majority of the team. Are they going to be able to complete the map in overtime? They do, Hex. Wow. Oof.
Yeah, I mean, Artyr got a little too cute on that defense there. He was hiding in the corner as McCree, but they had eyes on him. They spotted him, flashed him down, and then he died in that fight, and that consistent damage he was able to put out early wasn't there for the fight. But here's that huge Deadeye.
Yeah, this came off the Graviton Surge, I believe. Or not, no, it wasn't off the Graviton Surge at all. It was just, they're all sort of grouped for other reasons.
Well, they're grouped to try to benefit from the Transcendence.
Yeah. And that's the Transcendence. It's very, very quick healing, but it's not going to stop you from getting one-shot by McCree Deadeye. And look at Volataha's damage. That is a very gaudy damage number.
Oh my goodness.
15,125. Wow. Volataha putting in the work. So, That being said, this is about as beatable of a time as you get. 10-16. It's actually, it went into overtime levels, so there is a lot of time here for Flat Earth to come in and win the series.
Yeah, and it's been kind of, I don't want to say it's been back and forth because it hasn't been on the maps, but one map was back and the other was fourth, I guess you could say. So I don't really know what to expect on Dorada for this last point. That last map looked very evenly matched between the two teams.
Yep.
When you go into overtime, each team had good plays on either side. And it was, for the most part, they were just really scrappy fights. Just ultimates getting thrown down. And that at the end of the day, we just have to count the bodies.
Yep. So, again, switching sides here. This is the definitive map 3 for the series. Flat Earth versus Reunited. The time to beat is 10-16. And we might be in for a very, very close finish here, depending upon what Reunited team shows up.
Yeah, it's kind of one of the defining games early in the competitive Overwatch scene as far as Reunited goes. They need to start getting to finals and winning finals. And even if they win this, they've got G2 in their way next. But I think whoever wins this, and I think G2 moved on, I have to double check the brackets. Whoever wins this is in it for a tough fight against G2 based on what we saw earlier today.
So, taking a look at this from the defensive end, coming out from Reunited, we got Winston on defense, Valtaha, unfixed on the Winston, Valtaha on the McCree, Too Easy on Reaper, Bromass on Lucio, Winghaven on Reinhardt, and Morte, again, repping the defensive Symmetra.
Yeah, Symmetra has been good on defense on this map as well. I mean, really, it used to be only one or two maps that we saw Symmetra on defense, and it was like King's Row, but now she finds her way onto most maps. It's been a pleasure to watch, and I've actually enjoyed playing Symmetra because of it, because knowing that she has a place in the meta. Now, offensively, it's going to look pretty standard, nothing outside the box. They are running the Genyatta composition.
We're calling it Genyatta now?
Yeah, we could, and until someone finds something better, which shouldn't take long. And then they're running a Winston on offense rather than the Reinhardt, which is an interesting call.
Yep, so looking at this here, let's see. We have Genji right now doing the early poke to start with here, no surprise there. Time has been reset, it is now, there's about 10 minutes left for Flat Earth on the push here, so definitely, this is beatable.
This push is coming in really quick though, I'm surprised, like, I wonder if they're even going to be able to get a teleporter up on time, although this sentry turret damage is going to help into that effect. Oh, that ultimate is up, Morte is trying to retreat to find a spot to put down his teleporter.
The problem there is that Genji's getting out by a quick fire strike. He's a little bit out of position, and when you're running the Genji Zenyatta comp, you don't want your Zenyatta to die that quick on the push. But it's not really affecting them too much because they're still pushing the payload here, and Reunited is having trouble finding their footing.
Yeah, the Symmetra did go down, but the teleporter is up. I think they have eyes on where the teleporter is, as Winston's just going to camp it back here.
Yeah, that being said, Reunited was able to sort of shore up their defense towards the end, in part because of Altaha. The teleporter did go down, but honestly, we're seeing the power of teleport on this map. This is sort of the immediate reinforcement that we didn't see coming out of Flat Earth.
Yeah, Winston was over there to try to take out the teleporter. He knew where it was, but then people popped through the teleporter and he paid for it with his life.
Yep, so again, taking a look at things here. And this is the defense that really Reunited needs to come out with if they want to win this map. I mean, they have a lot of time to sort of defend off here, but the more the time they can make on the first point, the better.
Yeah, a very aggressive Transcendence, though. It's combined with the Lucio Speed Burst, and they're really repositioning their entire offense.
Yeah, the Deadeye is coming out for Valtaha here, but he doesn't really have the targets he wants. He is going to take out the Winston at the very least. Both teams trading off kills here. Drakeus going to just knock Valtaha on the head with the hammer, and starting to turn in favor of Flat Earth on this offensive run.
Yeah, a couple of picks to clean up there. He got super aggressive with that Transcendence. I really liked that aggression. Really redefined the battlefield, and now they're pushing them back, and they're going to get this card. This payload doesn't reach first.
Linksail gets it back and get the pick off on the Lucio. Vonathil, in fact, putting the exclamation point on the Reinhardt. So, Flat Earth getting through here in a reasonable time. And again, you look at the time that's left. They have a whopping 8 minutes left to bring this card all the way to the end, and that is very, very doable.
You know, the Symmetra's not getting a lot done here. The teleporters are coming up and turrets are going up, but they're getting eliminated immediately. They have to feel kind of like they're playing one person down here. They don't have the damage to finish these fights decisively, and it's because the Symmetra is just not a contributor in the fights, and she's actually not able to contribute in many other ways.
Just saw a big pickoff there. Too Easy able to take out Artier. Artier, of course, one of the bigger damage dealers for Reunited. And here comes, that being said, here comes Lynx. Lynx is looking for the flank Dragon Blade right now. Fighting the Reaper away from the entire fight. And,
Yeah, Dracarys had a good initiation there, but it was completely negated by the Sound Barrier that came down too, giving everyone those extra shields. Now, Lynx trying to do some poke damage now that shields are off, but they're going to have to retreat. This offense did not work at all.
That was just very, very confusing from my perspective. Like, they were just very split up, and they just did not really get on the same page for that push. And they had a whole bunch of ults too, so that was sort of a mistake. I think part of it came down from the fact that Lynx was a little bit tentative in how he set up his push. I think you had some people going in a little bit early before Lynx's L to get set up, and as a result, they didn't have that Genji pressure there, and that is a big, big loss.
Yeah, now we see a more coordinated push, though. The Transcendence comes out, but the tank's getting a little bit separated.
Yep, the Dragon Blade does finally come down. Too easy, though, already picking off two members of the Flat Earth team, and Lynx getting juggled by Winston in the corner. That is not what you want to see from a Genji. Unfixed, juggling Lynx, and Flat Earth is going to have to regroup here.
Oh, that depends how you feel about Genji. I enjoyed that scene very much. Now they are going to hold that defense pretty easily, and all the ultimates are up to, again, except for Winston's unfixed on Winston, of course, juggling the Lynx. So he's going to have to wait a little bit longer for his Primal Rage to come back up, but a great position for Reunited GG right here.
Yeah, Reunited is looking really, really strong here. They are buying some desperately needed time. Here comes the Deadeye coming out from Vlatov, but the shield's everywhere. He does not get any value on it whatsoever, and he gets taken out by Lynx in the back, so not quite what Reunited was looking for, though both teams are, again, trading off kills. That's the key thing about the series thus far. No fight has really been a total wipe and fair one team. They're very, very close fights until the very end, where one team finally comes on top, and it looks like Reunited is going to hold at this point.
Yeah, and you see that the hold is actually taking place now that Symmetra is off the map. The walk isn't too bad from this respawn point, and now they're actually having a bigger advantage in fights. They put a Zenyatta into the mix to start doing discords and some more healing, and the gameplay has absolutely changed on the fact that they're off Zenyatta, or Symmetra.
Yeah, taking a look at Too Easy here. Too Easy is going to be dropping down any moment. He almost has Death Blossom built up on the hole, and now he has to worry. He has Discord around him, has Lynx chasing him down. Here comes the hammer down from Dracaeus. Sound Barrier, though, comes out to negate some of this, including the Dragon Blade from Lynx, and some very nice counter ults coming up from Reunited, and this is looking good for them, Max.
Transcendence, three deaths too late. The big benefit of Transcendence is, of course, that it casts immediately. It was a little bit too late, and they were a little bit too scattered to fully take advantage of this. Almost looked like a desperation Transcendence.
Whoa,
there.
And look at how far Reunited is pushing out right now. They just went beyond the first second archway.
Yeah, we've seen teams do this here where they kind of push forward and look at the spawns, maybe trying to get someone who's coming out not entirely with their team, but then they just fall back. So we've seen it cost teams in terms of positioning sometimes, but it doesn't look like that's going to be the case here as Reunited falls back safely.
Yeah, and still keeping an eye on Too Easy. Too Easy's actually been on a very big kill streak. Unfixed able to pick some links off with the Winston. And again, Genji just not having the most success in the series as a general rule. Sometimes getting some good plays, but really has not been serious as much. That being said, a nice turnaround coming out from Flat Earth after a kind of questionable beginning. Really off the Peacekeeper of Arts here.
Yeah, Reunited took the defense on the aggressive there, and they went with the Transcendence in, but there was a very patient play by Flat Earth. They just waited for the Transcendence to come off and then started the fight on their own terms.
Yeah, we see a Deadeye coming out again. Perhaps not the most effective of Deadeyes. Both McCree's having some issues with that ult this game, and both teams brawling it out in the beginning here. Neither team has been picked off. Sound Barrier does go down for Reunited. Reunited's going to try and focus and get through here, but Dracaeus, nice Earth Shatter, results in the death of two people on Reunited. Lynx getting killed in the backfield, but here comes Vol'taha. Vol'taha with some very big cleanup, kicking off three people so far in this fight before finally getting taken out by Lynx in the end.
Yeah, he had a couple nice kills from inside Winston's fishbowl, which really helped him stay alive during that fight, but eventually everyone got cleaned up, and it gets scrappy, just scrappy trades for both these teams, and right there, that favored the offense. And you've got 2 minutes and, well, a little bit longer to push this point, and then we'll see what the official times are, but I think we're in for a close one.
The official time is 3 minutes and 13 seconds, and the reason for that, of course, is that it took them overtime to finish things out here. Oh, and Reaper did not punish Genji. He just walked right by the Reaper, and Genji, not punished for it, will go down anyways to the Winston. And Reunited again with a pretty substantial defense here.
Yeah, the tank's actually getting kills for Reunited right now. And again, they're trying to push a little bit forward. They want to hold right here and reestablish the battlefield here, I think. And then, well, you can't see here, but right at these doors. And then maybe watch the left-hand flank. But they can't get too aggressive as spawn points are very close right now.
Yeah, spawn points are in fact very close, and again, looking at the time, there's just not that much time left for Flat Earth here. It's certainly doable. They have maybe 1.5 to 2 pushes left. Ideally, they want to make something here, but they still have ults. If they burn ults here and don't get it, I think they're going to find it pretty hard to get it on the push after Hex.
Yeah, you kind of wonder if they're going to sell out and use both support ults to try to push in one big push, or maybe stagger them and use them separately, but the defense makes the decision for them.
Yep, Link's able to get the pick on Voltaire. That's a really big deal given Voltaire's contribution. Dragonblade does come out. Soundbear is up, though. It's going to hurt Dragonblade's contribution here. Winghaven takes out Lucio. Both teams trading kills back and forth here. It is a brawl over the payload. Don't really know what team's going to come out. Lynx, though, gets the Reinhardt, and it is looking like it's going to be a little bit in favor of Flat Earth here as they move forward towards the final point.
Both tanks for Flat Earth went absolutely insane on that push, and right now the biggest advantage is that Lucio still has his ultimate up, so this last push up the hill, when they start taking a little bit of damage, that Soundbear is going to come off and give them the extra push, but they lose their Winston early.
Yeah, they lost to Winston a little bit earlier, as you mentioned. They still have Soundbear. Maybe it's in their interest to save it a little bit, but really, they don't have that much time left here. They have a minute, but it's a hard call. Do you use the ult now and try and go on, or do you wait for everyone to come back up? But the decision is being made for them by Reunited as Too Easy goes in, drops the Death Blossom, and the entirety of the Flat Earth team is going to be pushed back. So they have one more good push left in them.
Yeah, it's a game of milliseconds. I really thought they had it right there when they had the sound barrier up. The other team was still spawning. They had the positional advantage to really finish that push, and they hesitated a little too long. And now that they have to one good push left in it, I really thought they had it right there.
Yep, and again, here comes Flat Earth. This is going to be and almost certainly the final push of the game. Lucio does have sound barrier. He is dropping the beat, and here they come.
Yep, so we're looking at this here. On both sides.
Winghaven, though, immediately takes out Drakeus. This is nice for Reunited. They have the tank advantage. Lynx takes out Winghaven. Both tanks are down. Volataha taking out Outsider. And again, this is looking really good for Reunited. Multiple people on the Flat Earth side down. Overtime is in progress, but it's not going to be enough. Reunited is going to take it in an extremely closely fought map number 3.
Yeah, GG's. And we've talked a lot about Reunited throughout this whole venture in these sets, but let's give Flat Earth some props there. They took Reunited to the limit.
Yep, let's take a look at R-Tier. R-Tier with the play of the game for Flat Earth. Honestly, some really good stuff coming out of R-Tier this series. Wasn't enough to win the final map, but really, he was McCreeing with the best of them.
Yeah, it's hard to even be a competitive team without a top-tier McCree nowadays. Everyone seems to run a very good McCree. Maybe McCree's a strong hero, but in the right hands, he's a game-winning hero.
Yeah, again, just really nice stuff coming out from them in general. So, Reunited takes it over Flat Earth in a closer series than I think people are expecting. Again, we did get the tip-off that Flat Earth has a pretty big Dirty Bomb pedigree, so maybe we're going to see some better stuff coming out from them as time goes on. Not actually sure if G2 had won against Paragon in the semifinals. We're going to get an update for you there. I'd be surprised if they didn't, but really, early Overwatch is all about upsets, so it's entirely likely. Because as you saw in this series here, Flat Earth came very, very close to unseeded and reunited and going to the finals.
Yeah, a very close match. Of course, Chalk still kind of holding Reunited that first round by, has eliminated the teams in their way. 2-0 at the first round, and then Flat Earth took them to limit. I'm interested in seeing Flat Earth as the team progresses too. They looked strong and very strong on some maps over others. No results yet on G2 Kinguin versus Paragon, but it is Reunited in their place in the finals.
Yep, that being said, we're going to take a short break as we prepare for the grand finals of the Ghosty Gamers Overwatch Weekly. I'm ZP, joined by Hex. Stay tuned, you won't want to miss the finals.